Thank you. Thank you. have a question for you, Sarah. It's also kind of for your dancers, but I don't want to ask them to answer right now. but maybe they can chime up later. I'm curious with your ideas of choreographing and balancing this with your other field of management, if you connected ideas of management and business with management of pacing energetic sustainability with their actual performative bodies. or what they're, maybe what I really want to know is what they learned about that connection, but they're out of breath, so you don't have to answer for them.
Well, I guess if you're related to energy wise, so the kata was performed with a mixture of chaos and order. And so I feel like throughout chaos and order, the energy levels go up and down because when they're order, then they're order, it's just like at like a stagnant level usually, but then there's chaos. And it was like it goes up and down. So I wanted to create something that represented like chaos and order. So and honestly, just thinking about their energy-wise, I don't, like, when I, like, create dances, I'm not thinking about, oh, like, I'm going to make this super hard, they're going to, like, die after, like, I'm not going to be doing that. Like, I want to just putting, like, some movement together, and then, like, you know, this happens to be, like, really breathy by the end. But the energy-wise, when I, like, work out, I'm not really thinking about, like, energy-wise, because, like, the amount of energy, but I think, like, maybe if it's, like, a slower piece, I think even, like, in the solo, where it's, like, slower, this you can put the same, you should have the same amount of energy as in like the last piece of the first piece that you should put in. And so it just made the energy output may like different versus the last, like the first and last piece might be more physical, but the solo and like the duet, the slower, it might be more mental and like through the energy wise.
The dancers, how did you manage your sustaining your energy?
I guess.
What did you learn about that?
You have to really breathe with your movement. There's no time to stand still and breathe at all. So I think that was key.
And I found myself in shoes. I'm sorry.
So I found myself using a lot of energy with solutions, and I really had to learn through this piece to not do that because I was taking so much energy.
Thank you. because she is choreographing, but learning the piece, we didn't learn it in any particular order, and for us, that was very chaotic up until literally today. But still today, it's like very chaotic in, oh, that phrase connects, what connects this to this? It's very chaotic for us, but then once we figured out the order of how things go and flow, it made it a lot easier, so I think there is also another balance of chaos and order in that too.
One small variation.
Very chaotic.
Yes. Sarah, I'm wondering if you could speak a little bit about your choice of music and how it might relate to your second area of study, that is management. I'm just curious.
So, part of the music choices I made is that I wanted to do something a little bit different that I would have done for like a main stage. Because I just had more freedom, so I decided the first two were Game of Thrones, and so, which was, I really love like the building up into intensity. That's like one of my favorite things about music. And so the first two choices were also just like, oh, like I have freedom to choose music I want to. So those were just like more free range choices. The solo to duet, I knew I wanted to represent more orderly, so they're not as chaotic as like the first and the last section. So I knew the solo was going to be a slower, like contemporary ballet-ish. Same with the duet, it's going to be slower, but more like maybe more modern. And then the last section was, I found this music and I just really enjoyed it. Like it really sounded like something like something I wanted to choreograph. And so, but other pertaining to my other major, just like when I thought about it, like the first and the quartet and the last section were probably more representations of like chaos and just like the duet representations of the duet. But I honestly just wanted to like have more, I think more freedom in music choices because I would never chose to do like Game of Thrones or like a main stage performance. So I just wanted to like work out from the kind of like fun.
Yes. Your thoughts of how were you able to work those situations out, which the dancers are, trying to know where to be different times without colliding, even though you feel being chaotic inside of it, but I just wonder what your notebook looked like with the issue of.
I didn't show you my notebook. It's like 70 pages.
Oh, really?
I really have a vision. You guys can look at it from all over the school. Yeah, if you want to see those notes, I'm glad to know. But the transitions, like you kind of like formations and everything?
Both transitions and to a practice.
Transitions are honestly like my weakest spot. Like I hate transitions. They're like so hard to come up. And so usually most of my transitions in this band were just like jumping to one phrase, which like I know is kind of like not like BS, but like, I just like don't know how to do like that. I really hate transitions. They're like so hard. But formations, I usually would just like lay out like pennies and like I just work around the pennies and formations. But most of them are pretty simple. If I'm doing like both formations, but I felt like most of these formations here are just pretty simple. I didn't want something like too like different. Most of the transitions are very fast too. They're like you have one jump or two jumps to get into the next spot. And so having like more difficult things, having like more time, well having less time to get into a transition. So I actually just kept most of the formation pretty simple just due to like the transition step to get into the next formation.
It's more of a comment. But I guess after watching choreograph for the past 17 years and so, there's really something unique about your choreography that I don't think you realize. But the fact that you push your dancers to the calendar so hard, it makes an audience member, more emotionally invested because I'm like rooting for them to keep going, but I'm also just like, oh my God. Like you don't do that. It's like there's something about, I was just saying like,
It's like I want them to have a moment to breathe, but you don't give them that. But that, like, pushing them harder, it just, like, makes me invested more and more in the piece. So I think that's just
I don't really realize I do that. Like, sometimes I'm like, this is a freaking moment. And so, like,
even though it's, like, really beautiful.
I like how you use all your dancers. They all had great parts. They're all balanced. You brought out the best in all of them.
So I didn't even notice you guys were here for like the whole day. I was like, I